Good morning, students. Today we'll be discussing screening of cDNA library. Today we shall be discussing about the screening of these cDNA libraries. In the screening of a library of cDNA, identification of cDNA clone of interest is done. This screening is based on four criteria. First is the DNA sequence of the clone. Second is the protein sequence of the encoded polypeptide. Third is a biochemical function of the polypeptide or the ability of the polypeptide, which is encoded by the recombinant clone, to interact with other polypeptides. We'll discuss some of the methods for screening of a cDNA library. The methods are nucleic acid hybridization, screening using PCR, immunological screening, or functional complementation. The first method is screening by hybridization. It is relevant to mention here that this is one of the most powerful methods, which is quite in use. This method does not rely on the activity of the protein, but requires sufficient similarity of the nucleic acid for stable duplexes to form between probe and the target sequence in library. It requires only the generation of some type of nucleic acid to be labeled as the probe. In this method, as we can see in the diagram, first a replica plate is prepared, then the transfer of colonies on nitrocellulose membrane is done. After this, in the next step, the disc is treated so that the DNA denatures, that is, the strands separate. In the next step, a single strand probe is added and the strands are allowed to re-anneal. After this step, the excess of the probe or the unbound probe is washed off and the filter is exposed to film. On developing an X-ray film, colonies that have annealed with the probe will appear on the film. After this, a comparison with the original petri dish reveals which colony is of interest. The next method is screening by PCR. PCR, that is polymerase chain reaction, is widely used to isolate specific DNA from library. It is possible if there is sufficient information about its sequence to make suitable primers. In this method, pools of clones are maintained in multi-wells and screened repeatedly until gene of interest is identified. Method for screening is by immunological assay, or this method is also called as immunological screening. Recently, antibody techniques have been developed to identify protein products of cloned cDNA. Suppose, if we have an antibody which is reactive to a protein or maybe a part of protein, the antibody can be used directly to detect if an E. coli or phage plaque contains the protein reactive to the antibody. As can be seen in the diagram, first of all, the clone is transferred on a nitrocellulose membrane to get similar pattern of colonies on the master plate. The cells on the membrane are lysed and released protein is denatured and allowed to bind the membrane. In the next step, treatment with primary antibody is done. In this step, the membrane is incubated with antibody having immunoreactivity towards a particular protein. The primary antibody will bind to the target protein due to an exclusive specificity towards antigen. The membrane is washed to remove the unbound primary antibody. In the next step, treatment with secondary antibody is done. In this particular step, the membrane is incubated with secondary antibody recognizing the primary antibody. The secondary antibody is labeled. The secondary antibody will now bind to the primary antibody and will allow the detection of the location of primary antibody. The membrane is washed to remove unbound secondary antibody. In the last step, an X-ray film is developed which tells us about the clone of interest. The next method for the screening of cDNA library is functional complementation. This method depends on the full biological activity of protein. It is the process by which particular DNA sequence compensates for a missing function in a mutant cell and thus restoring the wild type phenotype. If the mutant cells are non-viable under particular conditions of growth, cells carrying the clone of interest can be positively selected. The cDNA libraries are normally stored at minus 80 degrees Celsius. In order to avoid the adverse effects of freezing, cryoprotectants are added. Whenever we need to screen, a small lump of frozen stock can be removed and thawed. For some experiments, a complete cDNA library is unnecessary and instead a subtractive or a subtracted cDNA library is useful. A subtractive cDNA library contains cDNA clones corresponding to mRNAs present in one cell or tissue type and not present in a second type. This cDNA library is used to isolate a set of cDNA clones corresponding to a class of mRNAs or to aid in the isolation of a cDNA clone corresponding to a particular mRNA where the screening procedure for the cDNA clone is laborious. There are certain applications of the cDNA library. The complete cDNA library of an organism gives the total of the proteins it can possibly express. It also tells us about the biological function of individual genes, the changing patterns of gene expression that occur during differentiation of cells and tissues, how gene expression changes in mature cells and tissues in response to external factors such as drugs, etc. If we focus on the differences between a genomic library and a cDNA library, the source is genomic DNA in case of genomic library, whereas it is mRNA in case of cDNA library. The genomic library shows variation at the level of species or strains, whereas in cDNA library, the variation can be seen at the level of species or strains, tissues, as well as developmental stages. To summarize, a cDNA library is prepared by reverse transcribing a population of mRNA with the help of reverse transcriptase and is then screened for particular clones. It is prepared and then ligated to vectors such as plasmid or phage and then cloned in appropriate host. The screening of the library is done by hybridization or on the basis of expression of products like immunological screening. The cDNA clones can be effectively expressed in prokaryotic system. They are useful as they represent all the possible proteins expressed by a cell type. And with the help of a cDNA library, the biological function of individual genes can be identified.